Vamos a ver. ¿Está todo en orden? Sí. Parece que sí. Vamos a ver el chat. Muy buenas a todos. Es 25 de mayo del 2024. Son casi las 12 de la noche. O sea, es 25 por 2 minutos. Dentro de 2 minutos será 26 de mayo. No estoy en directo, parece ser. Estoy hablando solo. Espérate. No, no, estoy en directo. Está mamonado perdido. Bueno. Y eso, estoy completando. Yo creo que ya estoy finalizando. He hecho todas las secundarias. Estoy ya creo que finalizando el DLC, el de Blood and Wine, que nunca lo había hecho. Y estoy jugando en Nintendo Switch. Esta es la versión de The Witcher 3 de Nintendo Switch. Que por cierto, a mi parecer, no se ve mal. Y jugar este juego en portátil es una auténtica maravilla. Es una gozada. Y lo único en lo que le encuentro un errores a este juego, o sea, cosas que me saquen de quicio, es a la hora de abrir el menú y pasar por todos los objetos, va excesivamente lento. Pero el juego va perfectamente. Y bueno, este DLC trata de vampiros y viñedos, por eso se llama Blood and Wine. Ha habido un asesinato, ha sido un vampiro. Y acabamos de descubrir, porque Geralt tiene un colega que es vampiro también, un vampiro superior. Y hemos descubierto que el vampiro está siendo chantajeado, que se enamoró de una mujer y un grupo parece ser que ha... o una persona parece ser que ha capturado a esa mujer y está amenazando con matarla si el otro vampiro no mata a determinados objetivos. Entonces yo he optado por reconocer su inocencia, en el sentido de que, hombre, está siendo chantajeado, de que no está matando por voluntad propia, y se lo he explicado a, no sé si es la duquesa o la reina o lo que sea, no me acuerdo ya, marquesa, la marquesa de Rabotieso. Y tenemos una marca de vino que parece ser que es de donde viene.
How did it end? Did you kill it?
Didn't have to fight him. Hadn't killed anyone.
Have you ever heard of anyone defeating such a vampire?
Know of a man who defeated one, sure, but he didn't manage to kill it. Ultimately, only another vampire can kill a vampire.
Panthers have attacked the wagon. We must help.
That's it, Rose. Stay back your place. We shall see to this.
Help! Save us!
Me gustaría saber. Yo te digo una cosa, ¿eh? Estos errores de que yo esté ahí pegándole y no le esté haciendo nada, nada más que me ocurren cuando juego en la tele. Cuando yo estoy jugando en portátil, yo no tengo ningún error. Supongo que ahí recibirá una diferencia. Pero ya la última vez que se vea esto en televisión. Ya tuve la cámara Matrix. Niño esquizofrénico. Vamos.
Run, Roach.
Tell me more about this vineyard, Castel Ravello.
It's the best in all Tucson. An old master of the winemaking trade runs it, Fabrizio.
He trustworthy?
He's held his post for years. There's never been a problem, till now.
I wish to know your thoughts, Geralt. The Sonreal stain, how did it wind up on
the table? Eso están hablando de ello.
Is someone from the vineyard blackmailing the vampire?
Could be a servant. Y hay una mancha de vino en el papel de uno de los papeles de los objetivos del vampiro.
We shall know when we arrive.
Y no era, no era la letra del vampiro. Entonces, es la única pista que tenemos hacia el, posible chantajista.
Captain de la Tour, we did not expect any visitors from the palace. How are affairs at court?
Doubtless you've heard of the Beast of Beauclair. Well, we've our hands full. Especially since the rogue last attacked in the palace gardens.
I trust her illustrious highness was not harmed?
Kind of you to ask, Master Fabricio. I am well.
Your grace? We were not warned. I shall order the salon prepared at once.
That won't be necessary. As you can see, we are not here on an official visit.
Naturally. Might I ask then what has brought you to Castel Ravello?
Hostia. ¿Qué elegimos, tío? Queremos hablar contigo. O venimos a hacer una inspección directamente. Vamos a hablar.
Came to see you. Got some questions.
In this land, it is seen as polite to introduce oneself before asking any questions.
This is Geralt of Rivia, a witcher. He has come to Toussaint on my personal invitation.
Which is to say...
Which is to say I expect you to treat him with the utmost respect.
Of course, Your Grace.
Did you hear that, Witcher? Fabricio will be delighted to answer your every question.
Want to talk about Sanreal?
I am at your service.
The Sanreal. How many vineyard workers have access to it?
One might say only I do.
Not like you make the wine all alone. At least a dozen others work here.
I see you've little notion how wine is made. Grapes travel a long road before they become Sanreal. The workers assist me only to the stage of fermentation. I see to the maceration personally and let no one near the fat. Workers, again, assist me during barreling, but then I seal the aging barrels myself, each and every one. The wine lies in the cellar, gains character. Once this process is complete, it becomes Sanreal. And as it happens, only I have the key to the cellar in question.
Some of this wine might have been stolen. Just a suspicion we have, but any burglaries lately?
Burglaries? Not to my knowledge. And a few days past, I took stock of the inventory. All was accounted for. The barrels lie safely in the cellar, I assure you.
We'll not get anywhere asking questions, I see. It's a waste of time.
Your Grace? How am I to understand this?
Master Fabricio, we have proof someone's gained access to Sanreal. Someone who should not have. Which means one of two things. Either you lie to our face, or you are an idiot who has had wine stolen from under his nose and not even realized it. In either case, you shall answer for it.
But...
Silence! And listen. I shall inspect the barrels in person, thus giving you time to reflect. When I return, I expect to hear answers. Remind me, where is the Sanreal stored?
In the main cellar, around the corner. I'll show you.
I shall find it. Give me the key to the cellar and wait here.
Of course, Your Grace. Here it is.
Qué lástima, coño, Witcher. Me está dando pena el hombre. Estaba tan tranquilo en su casa y de pronto... Un disgusto, cojones.
We shall wait here, Master Fabricio.
What if Fabricio's blackmailing the vampire? considered that?
He has his flaws, but I would never suspect him of such a thing. He's been very loyal. He owes all he has to me. His father frittered away the family fortune. He left his son an encyclopedic knowledge of wine. That is all. Fabrizio lived as a beggar until I appointed him steward of Castel Ravello. Only then did he come into his own.
Por cierto, ni Jennifer, ni Trish, ni nadie, ¿eh? Ana Henrietta, para mí, es... En todos los sentidos, sería mi waifu. Carácter
y está cañón. Vamos
a ver si todos los barons están presentes. Aquí está el inventario.
Porque Jennifer es un poco capulla. Y Tris. Un poco mosquita muerta.
Log. Fermentation completed with no complications. Tapped above sediment line. Here it is, barreling. Everything lines up at first glance, neatly and thoroughly documented.
Then we must follow our other lead. Benoit said the stain came from the 1269 vintage. Let's find it.
Hostia, yo no me acuerdo de la fecha.
Hervelus. I like it. Quite dry.
An excellent wine. You've good taste.
Yo debo ser Don Simón de cartón. No soy para nada exquisito. Número 1 en cáncer de hígado. Siempre he querido tener un martillo de madera, gracias.
Est, est. Think everyone and their mothers heard of this wine.
Among the best in the world. Castel Ravello is famous for it.
Fiorano. Dandelion's favorite. Adores it.
Ah, yes. That sophisticated palate.
Got Pomino over here.
No te voy a decir con qué rima. Bueno, yo ya he mirado los tres. Discúlpame, querida. No me pase... El de Witcher 3, creo que me voy a poner con el Dragon Dogma 1. Que lo empecé. Además, Nintendo Switch.
Sanreal. 1270 vintage.
That's the wrong year.
Y lo dejé ahí un poco a medias. así que lo volveré a empezar de nuevo.
Sanreal. Barrels are dated 1268.
Close, but not quite the right year.
He hecho bien en dejarlo para el último.
Right here, 1269. What now?
Let's see if any barrels are empty.
Wanna open them?
For now, a knock will suffice. If you hear a hollow thud, we will have found what we seek.
¿Por qué es tan difícil, tío? ¿Por qué es tan difícil? ¿Verdad que esto, y esto es fallo del The Witcher 3, es que es muy complicado? Gracias. No, pues no, no me lo ha permitido. Ahora.
Full.
Eso también es un fallo que tiene el 2.
This one's full too. Full.
Qué complicado es el dar unos golpecitos.
This one's full too. Looks like all the barrels are full. Dead end, I'm afraid.
Full they are. The question is, are they full of Sanreal? Grab a tap and a hammer. We shall open them one by one and taste.
Ready. We can start. Ready.
Step aside.
Se va a coger una papa. Me la voy a tener que llevar a cuesta. Eso, échate un.
So.
Those hints of spice. Distinctive. This is Sanreal. I have a feeling we'll find something awry.
Lo que quería era ver.
Revolting, bitter plonk.
Could have gone sour while aging.
Impossible. This is not wine. This is contaminated refuse that should never have made it into a barrel. The fact that it did was no accident, I'm sure.
Master Fabricio, let's see what he has to say about it.
Toma.
Master Fabricio, I am very disappointed.
But your grace, I...
You are a step away from losing your head. Speak the truth and you might yet keep it.
I admit it. I sold a barrel of Sanreal. I beg you to forgive me.
Why did you do it?
I couldn't resist. The sum they offered, it was enormous. I gave in.
Is what I provide not enough?
I wished to buy back my family's estate. For here, nothing is truly mine. I've a roof over my head, ample food to eat, but... What is a nobleman without land of his own? I shall tell you everything if you agree to show me mercy.
Who'd you sell the wine to?
A few weeks past at the pheasantry, a rich nobleman approached me. He called himself a diplomat, well-connected at court.
He suggested we embark on an enterprise. Some of his clients had offered dizzying sums for even a drop of Sonreal. He was to serve as intermediary.
This man's name?
He never revealed it. He was tall, black-haired, and spoke with a foreign lilt. He claimed to hail from Sintra.
I've no Sintrian aristocrat at court.
Wine itself. How'd you hand it over?
We met under the cover of darkness in the ruins of Fort Astre. A dozen or so men came to collect. Armed men. The kind that stink of trouble. I had hauled the barrel there. They transferred it to their cart, and we went our separate ways.
That's it? At the last you ever saw of them?
That is to say, a few days passed. A messenger arrived. He said they wished to buy another barrel, and, well, I've prepared it. Have it ready to deliver.
Really thought nobody'd find out.
I was a fool. Very foolish. I beg you, Your Grace, you must forgive me.
That's enough. Know all we need to know.
Your Grace, I beg your forgiveness.
Get out of my sight. Captain, have your men take Master Fabrizio to the dungeon. He must answer for his crime. High treason the charge. What now, Witcher?
We set a trap. Need to catch the wine thieves. Sintrian Noble could be our blackmailer. Next, transport. I'll take it to Fort Astra. Damien and his soldiers will cover me.
For once, I agree with you. We will do as you say. Let me know when you are ready.
See no reason to wait. Let's get going.
We will set out now. Position ourselves before you arrive. You take the cart and meet us there.
Fine. When the handoff begins, watch for my signal.
Falta traición, tío. En verdad se ha pasado un poco, ¿no? A ver, a la mazmorra está bien. Unos días. A reflexionar. Y a lo mejor... relevado de su cargo también. Pero, tío, alta traición... me cago la leche.
Relax, now we wait.
Ah, our favorite vintner.
Me meten los pelos dentro de la oreja, coño. Es que me hacen cosquillas. Voy a meter un corte de pelo, pero ya. Peleando contra el zorro. a matar. A ver qué momento lo hago. Música de este videojuego es brutal. Pero brutal. Un bandido a la barbacoa. Rodeado al lado de Ghost Rider y su secuace.
Is it just me or did we agree you'd wait for my signal?
That was the plan, but...
Great shot. Good thing you reacted. Can't say how that would have ended otherwise.
At your service. It was a good fight. We managed to capture one of the scoundrels.
Let's ask him a few questions. Come on.
Witcher, a moment. I was wrong about you.
Don't need to like each other. Just gotta do our jobs.
If that's how you wish to treat it. At any rate, I see the effort you put forth. And I appreciate it. Let us go to her grace. She awaits nearby.
No. Yo no quería eso.
Not at all surprised.
The mo- is-
No.
Who's-
no, Wait, I'm- What?
Me cago en la leche.
Sure.
In that.
Lot.
What? No.
No sabía yo. Hemos venido a hacer lo que veníamos a hacer y punto, ¿sabes? Pero no el rollo de tú me caes mal. Que no me sale de los cojones, vamos. Nota me está pidiendo perdón y yo lo mando al carajo. Pues no es mi estilo. Hace falta tener la polla muy grande para pedir perdón. 020. 024, vamos a ver si es aquí. Pero es que tampoco quería... Yo no quería decirle no tenías motivos para confiar en mí. Entonces, hombre, diciéndole que yo no pasa nada. Ya está. Pero eso de que no tenía motivos para confiar en mí, una polla. Eso tampoco es así. Pero sí quiero aceptar sus disculpas. Entre aceptar las disculpas y no aceptar las disculpas, prefiero aceptar las disculpas. Pero es que la segunda respuesta, a mi parecer, no estaba claro que yo no estaba aceptando sus disculpas. En el sentido de, vale, pero me caes mal. No quiero contestarle eso, porque es mentira. De hecho, lo estaba pensando antes. Digo, aunque este tío se esté portando como un capullo, digo, en verdad no me cae tan mal, tío. Lo estaba pensando antes. Para ahora decirle exactamente lo que no quiero decirle, que es que me cae mal. Una polla, no me cae mal.
Is it just me, or did we agree you'd wait for my sig-
That
great shot.
At-
That-
Witcher.
Well, had no reason to trust me, and I didn't do much to change that.
True. You are not the most endearing of men. At any rate, I see the effort you put forth. And I appreciate it. Let us go to her grace. She awaits nearby.
Not at all surprised. Expected she'd want to oversee this personally.
The master's eye fattens the calf. You're beginning to understand that, I see. This prisoner of yours, bring him to me. We must ask him some questions. Captain, do the honors.
Who sent you?
His name is Dog. They say he plowed your mother.
Once again, who sent you?
Your nun's lover. They call...
Wait. He doesn't wish to speak. He needed. I can think of several other ways he can be helpful. I'm certain the Witcher will need bait to lure the beast of Beauclair.
What?
Sure can. Fresh out.
In that case, he's all yours.
Captain, have your men find me a strong rope. Kind that won't snap when we hang this fellow from a tree.
Rope?
Live bait. Great for monsters. Provided they catch the scent of its blood. But I'll see to that.
What? No. Crikey, no! Don't let them!
Stop screaming. Save your strength. Got a long night ahead of you.
No! Don't let him! I'll talk!
Barrels. Where were you gonna take them?
I don't know!
Captain, need that rope after all.
I truly don't know! Hornet's the leader, only he ever knew where to go. But he lies over there, dead. That one. The first barrel went to a warehouse at the port. But where this one was bound, I don't know! I speak true, you must believe me!
Who hired you?
He'll kill me!
Ought to be worried about me right now. Who is he?
Go on, man. Spit it out.
The Sintrian. That is what they call him. I've never seen him, but I know he mustered the men for this caper. That's what they said, that we were working for the Sintrian. I don't know anything else. I swear it.
Take him away. Throw him in the dungeon. He shall await trial there. Captain, we ride to town. Gather your men and seek out the Sintrian. Someone else must have seen him, must know of him.
Yes, Your Grace. I'll report to the palace as soon as I learn anything.
I shan't return to the palace. Our mission has not yet ended. The Witcher and I will await you at the guard post near the port.
Let's go to town.
He's late.
Relax, he'll come.
There's something I'd like to know. How can you be so damned calm?
Side effect of my mutations. We Witchers rarely get the jitters.
What if something has happened to him?
Captain seems like a man who can take care of himself.
Perhaps he can, but this Sintrian appears to be no common bandit. He managed to steal ducal wine from under my guardsman's gnosis. We only learned of it through a fortunate coincidence. And it was he who specified the victims for the vampire. One must be exceptionally confident to blackmail such a monster.
Still don't know this Sintrian's behind the kidnapping and blackmail. Might have just handled the theft of the wine.
Even if it's so, he then sold the wine to the blackmailers. As I see it, that makes him an accomplice.
Need to find the Sintrian, whether or not he's responsible for the murders. Even if none of it's his doing, he could still know our blackmailer's identity. Besides, it's one thing to know who ordered the killings. other thing entirely, and just as important is why they... Someone's coming.
Captain, why so long? We expected you hours ago.
This Sintrian does not work alone. We are fighting an organization, not one man. Bandits attacked us, not a small force either. One of my boys has a broken arm, another a shattered knee, lamed for life. And the word on the street is there's a hefty bounty on your head, Geralt.
Used to it. Not the first time I've been hunted.
Must you always? Now, the port warehouse where the wine was delivered, we identified it, then learned who had hired it out. This proved to be a beggar, a stand-in. We found him. He admitted all. A man had paid him to sign the lease, a man he met while begging outside the pheasantry. There, fate lent us a hand. A waitress recalled spilling wine on a nobleman who spoke with a Sintrian accent.
What did he look like?
Her description was not helpful. Handsome, well-dressed, with a beard. No distinguishing marks. This could be anyone. But she remembered his female companion very well, as she recognized her. On the Sintrian's arm was Cecilia Bellant.
A singer? I've heard of her. She's said to be gifted, fairy.
The same. We went to her home immediately. Cecilia was not there, but we questioned her servants. A chambermaid claimed Cecilia is to meet a Sintrian gentleman tonight. She'd invited him to a reception mounted by the Mandragora.
The Mandragora? What's that?
A club. An affiliation of local artists. Painters, sculptors, troubadours and dancers.
Never heard of it.
They exude mystique, consciously, I think. Behaving like an exclusive cabal. Artistic elites. Every now and again they mount soirees. Only wealthy patrons are invited. All arrive in elaborate masks, then drink and flirt.
Gotta nab the Sintrian. Seems we have to go to that get-together.
You read my mind, Witcher. I shall gather my men, surround the establishment. Not a mouse will squeeze through.
Out of the question. If the Sintrian truly does have men about the city, he will find out and escape once again.
Duchess is right. Need to be careful. Best go there, blend in with the crowd.
Precisely what we shall do.
We, Your Grace.
Geralt and I. In that sort of company, the Witcher could use my help.
Where's the event going to be held?
The Mandragora always assembles at the same place, a residence in Hauteville. It's a very distinguished district. Geralt, you must don appropriate attire. Then meet me in Hauteville, in Mountebank Alley.
Patrols, just in case. Good luck. I hope you get the bastard. Greetings, Witcher. Remember, you are in Beauclair, an orderly city.
Bueno, pues vamos a buscar una ropa hermosa. Por cierto, la espada de Geralt de Rivia no puede ser más fea. ¿Qué pasa aquí? ¿Cómo reparte aquí?
How long you gonna make me wait?
Matado al Qué bueno.
Didn't look like locals. Damien's right. I'm a hunted man.
Qué chulo. Vamos a arreglar la espada y la armadura. Vamos a ver. Ya estamos listos.
No touches around this place.
Estoy muy lejos. Algo de lo que he cenado me ha tenido que sentar mal, porque tengo el estómago regular. Estoy aquí haciéndome el tipo duro, pero la verdad es que cada vez me duele más. Coño de mi prima.
Begone from my sight.
Don't crowd around.
Estoy muy salmorejo por la noche. Quizá demasiado fuerte, no lo sé. Ahora mismo yo podría matar al vampiro solo con mi aliento. Porque la verdad es que tiene bastante ajo.
Sacre bleu. It's a crime. You're from the north, that's painfully clear.
Excuse me?
There is no excuse. There is but the need to outfit you anew. My salon stands open. Please come in.
Vamos a jugar primero al Wing un poquito.
In the mood for a round of Gwent?
¿Para qué cojones quiero yo esto, tío? Qué mala suerte, cojones, tío. creo que tengo bastante aquí para dar caña. Vamos a empezar fuerte. Bueno, no tan fuerte. Vamos a ir despacito. Así. Venga, vale, pues... caña. Eso de inteligencia artificial se queda en artificial nada más. Ay, ya te he ganado, yo lo dejo así ya. No vas a hacer con dos cartas, no vas a hacer tantos puntos ni de coña. Hijo de puta. Venga ya. Qué barbaridad, 200 cartas. ¿Qué? ¿Por empate gana la ronda? Antes que te dé. Dame la ropa.
Ah, welcome back to the Northern Dandy.
Allá te la di.
All jests aside, let me see what you got in your wardrobe.
I'm more than willing, sir.
Diría que ya está. ¿Esto qué es? Coño, creía que la mejor armadura que tenía era la que llevaba puesta. Toma esto para ti. Venga, que te voy a ganar otra vez. Y así recupero un poco de dinero.
In the mood for a round.
He tenido suerte con las cartas, a lo mejor me he venido un poco arriba de volver a jugar contra ellos. Querés superarme. Dice que me ponga el atuendo. A ver, quiero ver esta armadura. Hostia, es guapa en verdad, ¿eh? tuviera el pelo largo y suelto, me parecería a Kane, tío. Y sería la polla, en verdad. Bueno. ¿Caballo también quiere coger ropa o qué? Sardinilla muerta. Venga, sardinilla. Luego te llevo al Corte Inglés. Vámonos.
Let's go.
Late. Now, why does that not surprise me?
Well, well. I did not expect you to have such a sense of style. Not all bad. Nothing like a budding artist, of course, but... Just one other detail. Here, put it on.
A mask?
All who attend the Mandragora soiree wear them. If you have one on, no one asks who you are.
Any idea why they wear masks?
Likely because they imagine it oh so very romantic and mysterious. The truth is far simpler. This way, no one can tell which drunken aristocrats are pinching the performers.
Let's go. Soiree's started.
Mm-hmm. Wise of you to hide your weapons. They'd not have let us in otherwise, that's certain.
Ha sido la cinemática, yo no sé.
How do we find this Cintrian? Have you a plan?
Key is not to spook him. Need to ask after his partner, Cecilia, first. Less likely to raise suspicions. As soon as we find her, we find him. Especially since he might be expecting us.
What do you mean?
Ran into some of his thugs in town. Knew who I was. Had it in for me.
Right. Right you are. We must proceed with caution. Come, it's our turn.
Madame, Monsieur, an extraordinary pleasure to welcome you to the Mandragora's soiree. Tonight, I particularly recommend you direct your attention to the performances prepared by artists of our community.
Tell us about these performances.
This evening, the Mandragora has the honor to present three superb displays of artistry. The first was a concert by Cecilia Belont. A singer whose voice, were it stone, would surely be a diamond. Sadly, Mademoiselle Cecilia has sung.
Shame. You would have loved to hear her.
Luckily, you are in time to see the great Calesti, a master of visual illusions, come to us from far off Afir.
Visual illusions. Interesting. And the third artist?
The third and fourth for the Ara duo are the Tuven brothers, presenting their newest pantomime.
We were really hoping to meet Cecilia Ballant.
You are admirers, I surmise. I'm certain you will have ample opportunity to converse with her.
It cannot be easy to identify anyone in this crowd. Perhaps you could help us find her.
I don't know where she is now, but I can give you a clue.
Let's hear it.
Seek the Kaviri Orchid.
Meaning?
Cecilia wears one in her hair. You shall recognize her easily by the orchid.
Well, well. Dandelion's always complaining about artists being poor as temple mice.
The residence belongs to none of them. They are guests here. Oriana, she owns this. Woman in the black dress, there on the balcony.
Got her. Doesn't wear a mask?
It would be pointless. All would know her anyway.
Kaviri Orchid, let's look for it. If we find Cecilia, we'll find the Cintrian.
Bueno. Yo voy a participar en los eventos de la velada, eso es un hecho.
Put your own house of Porter first.
Bring the stones of the soul.
Go on, Geralt, be bold. Show us the artist in you. The page boys, cast them at the canvas.
Ana, le va a la marcha. Venga, vámonos.
Please do not disturb.
Good folk, yet another soul longing.
Pero como la lanza. Creo que he hecho muchas soplapolleces de los videojuegos, pero es posible que este entre en un top 3.
Absinthe, the preferred hooch of artists.
Careful, it That's a pretty powerful punch.
I've built up a pretty powerful resistance.
Vamos a la siguiente prueba.
Your voice, as you've made no effort to understand, it's a metaphor of the constant struggle for power.
Let's look in the alcohol.
What else do they think of? If they can't agree, they can cut the line.
Bueno, ¿cómo se participa en esto?
Constant struggle.
Do take care, Mitchell.
Greetings. My deepest regrets.
Solamente que ve cómo estos dos gilipollas hacen el gilipollas.
Ignoramus.
Espérate.
She ought to be in one of the alcoves.
Ay, qué cosa más complicada, tío. Esto es como llevarse un tupper a una fiesta, ¿no? Lo llevo todo.
In one night, the theft of the century. And here? Please leave. This is a private alcove.
How fares your health, sir?
Cecilia never should have performed tonight. You should have.
It seems someone decided otherwise.
That someone knows nothing of true art.
It shall be you next time. Trust me, I shall have a word with Oriana personally.
We wish to be alone. Please, leave.
Pero aquí no hay juego alguno.
You understand? There are a great many hut. We wish to be alone. Please.
Aren't they even? Because the right club seems somewhat tired to me.
It's fine. Relax. Master level.
Look at the mage. I believe he's casting spells.
Yeah, we'll see.
Lanterns. They say releasing them brings good luck.
Do not take care of it.
Ah, how beautiful.
Fine. Let's give it a try.
Rodolf never suspected you believed in such things.
Bueno, no ha sido muy divertido. Vamos a buscar a esta mujer con la orquídea en el pelo.
I was prepared for all sorts of criticism, but pretentious. Blah blah blah. Affontgard, schmaffontgard. It's all about two things: coin and copy. Do not disturb! Shoo, shoo!
Mm-hmm. It's the right flower.
Of course it is! A Kaviri orchid lends just the right contrast to her complexion.
Need to talk to your model. It'll only take a minute.
To me?
Lie still! You may speak, but for love's sake, do not move.
Wow. Impressive portrait.
I know the style, the stroke. This is Dorian Villes.
The gracious lady has heard of me?
I've heard Anna Henrietta herself wished you to paint her portrait once.
At one point, the palace chamberlain even wrote to me, but alas, ultimately refused my terms.
What was the matter?
When he learned I only ever paint nudes, he severed all contact. He said he would not dare offend her illustrious highness with such a proposition. I've always longed to paint her. Such a shame.
Yo también.
I think you may still get your chance.
We came here to meet you, specifically.
To meet me? But why?
Oh, no.
Cintrian Noble you came here with. Wanted to ask you about him.
Cintrian Noble? Ah! You must think I'm Cecilia.
Orchid confused me.
I told you not to move!
As she concluded her performance, Cecilia tossed the flower into the crowd. I caught it. But I did see the nobleman.
Really liked to talk to him. What did he look like?
Like many here. Tall, dark, masked.
Know where he might be now?
He gave Cecilia a small gift, a heart-shaped box. Then they strolled off together towards the refreshment tables.
Excuse me, madame, monsieur, I cannot work like this. You must leave now.
Me van a banear de todos lados. Yo lo odio, tío.
Someone left their loot behind. Looks a little like dandelions.
This was scratched. Someone beat him once.
Love letter penned on a napkin. Look.
Oh, my amour, my sunbeam flittering across the firmament of my life. Trickly left.
Empty heart-shaped box. Cecilia must have left it behind.
It looks like it held a flask of perfume. A gift from the Cintrian.
Scent still hangs in the air. Let's follow it. Hit of Fistech. Artist's way of numbing their existential pain.
And they're not even wish to comment.
I
take care of each other.
Welcome. Aren't they Ethan? Because the right cup seems somewhat higher to me.
It's fine. Relax. Master Bouvon is a general.
Sorry, only artists in the Mandragora allowed.
Come. We must consider what to do.
I'd recognize that voice anywhere.
You must be mistaking me for someone else.
I served 15 years in the palace. Your Grace, I'd not mistake you for anyone.
Shh! Not so loud. We are here incognito, on state business.
Yes, Your Grace. How may I serve?
I hope we can count on your discretion.
Of course. I shall be silent as the grave.
Looking for Cecilia Bellant. Seen her?
She's in her dressing room, where she went with a nobleman. They clearly were drawn to each other.
What did the man look like?
Tall. Broad-shouldered, a black beard peeping out from under his mask, and he spoke with a foreign accent, a drawl of sorts.
That must be him. We must get to the dressing room, quickly.
Yes, Your Grace. I'll take you.
No, stay here. Anyone tries to flee, you stop them.
Understood.
Quickly, upstairs. Must be Cecilia.
No pulse. We're too late.
He slit her throat. The brute.
Didn't go out the door. Guard would have noticed. Might still be somewhere here.
You must find him before he harms another. I shall alert Oriana at once. She should bring her soiree to a close.
Shouldn't split up.
Geralt, I will be fine. Go after that rogue. I shall fetch help.
Bloody handprint. It's his. Tore down the door. Made a platform. Clever. Must be pretty strong, too. Killed her, then went out on the balcony. Broke the flower pot when moving the door, then stepped in the soil. Footprints made by soiled boots. Must have climbed this ladder. Could still be here. Need to stay alert. Smashed mirror. Someone crashed into it hard, then sank to the floor. Bloodstains. Links of a snapped chain. Jewel must have been on it. precious stone. Bloody fingerprint on it. Thief came for this, must have. Tiny chain links next to it. From a snapped necklace. Seems there was a struggle. Jewelry box. Lock's busted. Picked open, probably.
Tiene cojones, ello. Quiero darle a examinar y lo que hace es coger la planta. Cuando ni siquiera estaba en la cámara.
Sconce is bent. Smeared with blood. Someone tried to grab it. Blood on the window frame. Someone climb out? Fall out? Looks valuable, but it's not what he came for. Empty inkwell. Knocked over, turned toward the room. Hunting knife. Richly ornamented. Used during the fight, probably. Jewel was in the box, it seems. Centrion tried to steal it, but someone got in his way. They fought, struggled, that's clear. Ended with one of them flying out the window. Fall had to have killed them. Jewel's still here, though, so our Centrion must have been the flyer.
So, this is the tracker. A witcher, yes?
Indeed, this is him. We found the body together. Then he set off in pursuit of the killer.
And ended up here, but I've only found evidence of a fight. Seems the Centrion's killed his last. Finally failed this time. Shame it happened too late for Cecilia.
Poor girl. Always told us she chose her males badly. But I would never have suspected she could arrive with a murderer. I'll alert the staff. Have them see to her body at once. Meanwhile, we should sit. I will tell you everything in full detail. I caught him red-handed, attempting to burgle, rifling through my possessions.
What did you do? Summon the guards?
There was no time. I feared he'd escape, refused to give him the chance. He stood with his back to me, so I attacked. He struck his head on a picture frame as we struggled. He was bleeding, dazed, and then he drew a knife. Everything happened very quickly then. I knocked the weapon out of his hand and pushed him hard. He
fell out of the window.
Just so.
None too wise picking a fight with an armed robber.
Why? Because I'm a woman, in a frock rather than plate. I can take care of myself, I assure you. A hairpin might look like mere ornament, but plunged into an eye, it can be as effective as a blade.
Claim the man was trying to rob you when you walked into the room?
Yes. He stood over my dressing table, pouring through my jewelry.
Mm-hmm. After this is my guess. Picked it up while searching.
Why, that's the heart of Toussaint. Oriana, how did you ever come to have it?
I bought it, many years ago, from a young woman.
Jewel seems important. Why?
The heart is an heirloom. It belonged to my family for years. Then it disappeared. I didn't think we would ever recover it.
Seems someone is very determined to find it. The thief left his tool bag behind. Found this drawing inside it. Look.
The heart of Toussaint. Representation's pretty faithful. Centrion must have been on a job. Got very clear instructions what to look for.
So it is not him we seek, but his employer. Is this the only evidence we found?
Also happened on the weapon he attacked Oriana with. Hunting knife. Used to skin game. Got an emblem on its hilt.
This crest is used by the Lords of Duntine. The present master of the castle is a passionate hunter. Our next lead, perhaps.
Duntine. Remember the place. Abandoned ruin just a few years ago.
More recently, the family's last heir, Roderick, returned to his ancestral seat and restored the castle.
Know any more about this Roderick?
His grandfather was an advisor to Queen Ademarta. The family received those lands as a grant for his service. Roderick is quite the recluse. He avoids society, preferring the company of a small team of knights. Though the latter term is imprecise, as they seem more akin to vandals with crests on their shields.
Un momento, quiero buscar algo. A ver, Discord. Vale. Un momento. Que me han hablado de Wallapop y quiero verlo. Listo. De todas formas, después de esta conversación voy a dejar ya el directo, estoy un poco cansado.
Oriana, everything we discussed here, hope you'll keep it to yourself. Counting on it, in fact. Word gets out he, failed in his attempt to steal the jewel. His employer could run. We need to proceed cautiously.
Discretion is in the interest of us all. I'll not ask what this is about, just as I expect not to be troubled about it again. By anyone.
Forgive me, Madam Oriana, but might I have a word?
You must excuse me a moment.
Qué tía más rara, Guillo.
Oriana, any thoughts?
Few make me feel awkward, but in her presence, I sense anxiety, discomfort.
The drawing. It's on the same type of paper the victims' names were written on. Drawn with the same ink, too. Seems the work of our blackmailers.
Who were not only behind the Beast's murders, but also stole the Sonreal and sought to steal the heart of Toussaint.
Look, the wine, the jewel, both tied to you intrinsically. Coincidence? Not something I'm willing to believe. Worried about one thing. That somewhere at the end of this scheme, plan might call for an attempt on your life.
It could be something else altogether. My sister, Siana, might be among the schemers. She left court when we were children. My parents banished her from the duchy. I've not seen her since.
Think your sister might be involved? Why?
You see, I recall her always being rather possessive, throwing jealous fits if I had something she didn't.
Here, that's normal for sisters. Rivalry.
True. I suppose I gave as good as I got. There are times I miss that very much. The wine, its theft, was the first clue. That's very much like her. She always did enjoy stealing my toys. But I grew almost certain when I saw the heart of Toussaint. Siana received it from father as a gift. At a time when my parents thought of her as but an ill-behaved little girl, someone wanted some of my wine. The same someone ordered our family jewels stolen or recovered. It's my sister. It must be.
A fallen princess satisfying whims, going after lost luxuries? Could be right. What did your sister do to get banished?
Siana was cursed.
Parents run afoul of some mage?
No. She was born at an inopportune moment. They said she was touched by the curse of the Black Sun. Geralt, is it true? Can an individual be evil because they were born during the wrong lunar phase?
Could be the case. Could also be because they were treated like lepers from birth. Isolated, prodded, ostracized. Couldn't have had it easy, Siana.
She was angry at the whole world. She felt inferior, felt pain, though she masked this with confidence, arrogance even. She could also be cruel at times. I recall one such situation. She persuaded Cedric the Coolbert that she could see the future in her dreams. We were children, and Cedric's brother was smitten with me. It was an innocent childhood crush. Siana knew of it. She told Cedric of a dream she had had, that he would die at the hands of his own brother. Cedric stole his father's sword and killed his brother. She destroyed two lives with a prank. Cedric mourns to this day. In the end, they forced her to leave the palace. A decade passed, more. I've missed her terribly since. Your mission has gained new import. You must go to Dun Tyne, and if Siana is there, you must find her. No matter what she did, she is not to be harmed in any way, shape, or form. You must make sure of that.
No prometo nada, en verdad es lo que yo diría.
Can't guarantee her safety, unfortunately. Especially if she's one of those responsible for these crimes.
Witcher, that was not a request.
Your Grace, Geralt, I'd like to introduce...
Regis! What a surprise! I had no idea you were in Beauclair. And this is...
My very dear friend, Detlaf van der Eritain, an arrival from Nazaire.
We are lending our combined resources to the Witcher's Hunt.
Ah, yes. Splendid. But why are you here at Oriana's?
They came to pay me a surprise visit, so I invited Regis in for a glass of wine. We've known each other for... ages. Literally. Witcher, I hear you know Regis too. even that you are friends.
Few I can rely on like I can on Regis. Kinda hoping he thinks the same of me.
Curious. It seems opposites really do attract.
Don't be fooled, dear. Geralt has many merits. He merely hides them from the world very diligently.
You said you're both aiding him with his contract. It involves the Beast of Beauclair, I suspect. Master Witcher, maybe you could satisfy my curiosity. What's it like going toe-to-toe with a monster, knowing you've only two options, to kill or be killed?
Despite what you might have heard, I don't lunge at every monster I see, sword in hand. Talking gets the job done for some.
I wonder what a monster might have to say to you.
It might want to apologize.
My word. For what might a monster wish to apologize to a witcher?
For killing. Though at times there is no choice, when loved ones are at risk and require protection.
Same as humans. Put them in that situation, they'll kill too.
You understand this. It must be why you and Regis are friends. If I understand you correctly, you would rather help a monster than kill it.
If possible, yeah. Or at least try.
Enough about the Witcher trade for now. Regis mentioned you come from Nazaer. I spent time there as a child.
Fond memories?
It was wonderful. I was positively entranced by the land's fashions. Deep-cut dresses I found most fascinating.
I believe we're running short on wine. I should go to the cellar, bring another bottle.
Let me go. Want to help Regis? Know your wine a lot better than I know mine.
We shall return forthwith.
Yo no lo dejaría con la duquesa, pero ni de coña. Por mucha sonrisa y mucho perdón que diga.
An exceptional conversation, don't you think? Vampires, a witcher, and the Duchess of Toussaint? My, my.
Highly exceptional, Regis. Wanted to talk to you in private. You crazy bringing Detloff here?
Geralt, allow me to explain.
No, let me explain. He's dangerous, and you are gonna watch him.
But that is precisely what I'm doing. Detloff believes you'll succeed in your task, and he'll not need to kill anymore.
That is, not until he gets his hands on the men who kidnapped his Renner.
Ojo, voy a tener que elegir entre la hermana y el nota este.
Orianna, she really your friend? Can she be trusted?
I met her years ago, before I met you, and before she settled in Beauclair. We'd not seen one another in... I can't begin to tell you in how long. But I shall tell you all about her some other day.
Guessing it's no accident you two stopped by.
It would be quite some coincidence indeed. No, a dutiful little bird told us.
Now listen close. Managed to learn where the blackmailers are. They're based at Duntyne Castle.
That's splendid news. If they are there, Renner must be there as well.
Duchess expects we'll find her long-lost sister there too. Thing is, she might be involved. Could be behind the blackmailing.
Do you mean to say your task now is to extract two women from the castle?
Mean to say we can't breathe a word of this to Detloff, who wants revenge above all else.
Geralt, you must trust me. I've got a way with...
No, Regis. Can't risk it. Gotta keep Detloff here while I go to Duntyne.
Alone?
Alone. That way I can make sure neither woman will come to any harm.
I hope you know what you're doing. Fine. I shall see to Detloff. Good luck, my friend.
Splendidly, Detloff. Ah, I'm grateful you brought back those memories. You're back! It took you long enough.
Contrary to what common folk believe, choosing a wine is not nearly as easy as it might seem. Especially a wine to be served to two exquisite ladies.
Regis, gallant as ever. I regret all the more that I shan't finish this second bottle with you. Duty calls.
Your Grace, always a pleasure.
I thank you for your help. It's been invaluable. Geralt, will you see me out?
Aideo Kojima
You have exceptional game. Friends. This Detlef, an intriguing man to say the least.
Don't know him too well. He say much about himself?
Not much, but I've a good sense of the true nature of those I meet. I'd not survive a week at court otherwise.
So what's his?
Sensitive. Sad. He carries within him the weight of a terrible tragedy. He is a good man, but lost, which is why he comes across as grim.
Didn't expect the evening to end like this.
Neither did I. But I have not drawn you out for a romantic stroll.
Vaya por Dios.
I wish to make certain you know what you are to do.
Mm-hmm. Gotta go to Dantine.
I've decided my guardsmen will support you. You will meet them at Count Delacroix Mill. It stands along the Saint-Retour River, near the Cockatrice Inn. Captain de la Tour and his men will await you there at midnight. You shall storm the castle together.
Hmm. Me voy a poner mi armadura. Voy a guardar la partida. Misiones. El tesoro no queda ninguno. El juego del hambre. Venga, vamos a hacer esta que se ha activado. Y así también hablamos con el mayor. Estoy ya un poco quemado. Tan quemado que no me acuerdo de los puñeteros botones. Joder, que yo. Mikeli. Bienvenidos a Mikeli. La 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 la. Estoy pensando cómo voy a quitar las tetas. Hay una opción en YouTube, me parece, a la hora de subirlo. Te permite editar el vídeo y cortar partes y demás. Para no tenerlo que renderizar expresamente. Parece que quitaré esa parte y punto.
I do not know how I will ever repay you, Witcher.
Don't expect to be paid. Hope you're feeling better, that's all.
Oh, yes, I feel my strength returning thanks chiefly to Barnabas Basil's care.
Horrible ordeal you endured. Glad I cut it short.
Yes. Years of suffering. You know what was worse than the hunger? Watching my loved ones, my children grow old and die. All my family's long gone now. The last of my kin perished decades past. I fear I've nowhere to go.
This is a big house, big estate. You can stay here.
Truly? I could... never infringe so on your hospitality. Yet...
Yeah.
After all I've suffered, the years of starvation, I've but one dream. At last to prepare food that fortifies, nourishes, to delight in the tastes and smells of spices, to sit at one table with others and eat.
Don't see a problem if that's your dream. You could help Barnabas Basil in the kitchen. Eating his meals. You know he's not a culinary virtuoso.
Nothing could make me happier. Thank you.
No, thank you. House could use a woman's touch.
I've one other thing I'd like to tell you. Many years ago, my father assembled valuables for my diary. I never went, so they remained unclaimed. These baubles are no use to me now, but to you. Well, perhaps let them be a token of my gratitude. If you wish to find them, you must go to my old home, to Trastamara. The dowry lies hidden in a barrel in the cellar. There are several barrels. You must give each a knock until you find the right one.
Do just that. Thanks. I'd never expect someone with your past to feel drawn to the kitchen.
Do you fear I will cook in your home as I brewed as a white?
Counting on you having slightly better taste as a human.
Of that, you can be sure. I loved cooking, even as a child. My gran was a true master in the kitchen. Her spit-roasted ox was famed throughout the land.
Thought you were a lady, owned an estate.
Do you mean to say a woman of my rank should have had a cook? You're right, of course. And I had the best of cooks. But I devised the dishes myself. They only prepared them.
You sure you don't feel lonely out here?
I cannot say yet. Too little time has passed since you freed me of my thrall. But somehow, for now at least, I do not feel drawn to the city, to others.
Visited others' homes as a white?
Yes, but ever at night, when all were asleep, I went in search of spoons.
Remember, you can always change your mind. Decide you've lived here long enough, just say the word.
I'd never wish to seem ungrateful.
And I'd never want you to stay against your will. See you later.
Take care, Witcher. And remember, you always have warm food awaiting your return.
Mira qué bonito está mi casa ya. Johnny, pasa hijo.
Renovations coming along all right.
I am delighted to inform you we have completed our labors. You can now devote yourself to enjoying the vineyard's delights to the fullest. You must forgive me my temerity, sir, but I thought with all the work on Corfo Bianco completed and with the estate looking more beautiful than ever, it might be appropriate to commemorate the moment.
Sure, why not?
During the tidying that preceded the renovations, I came across a bottle of Sapramento, the 1250 vintage. I cannot say by what miracle it survived, but it is here. And we've course to open it today. And then he ran straight into the crowd, burning bouquet in hand. All thought it a part of the performance, so they only laughed, even when the decor began to catch fire. It was not until the flames engulfed Baron Mahefkin's beard that folk began to realize something was amiss and went to put out the fires.
Sounds like Monsieur Bolius and Madame Nina threw some first-rate balls here.
It was so. In this regard, Baron Rossel was decidedly more reserved.
So tell me, Barnabas Basil, what's the wine situation like here? Am I going to produce any this year?
This year is out, I fear, sir. Last autumn, a fungus destroyed all the vines. Baron Rossel had new ones planted, but it will be some time before they start bearing fruit. Assuming that is,
the fungus does not reappear.
That'd be bad. This Sepramento got me dreaming. It's amazing.
Isn't it, though? Allow me to top you off, sir. There.
Thanks.
Bueno, para aquí lo dejo. La verdad que los DLC están bastante guapos. Me gustó mucho el otro de Corazones de Piedra. Y este de Sangre y Vino me está gustando también mucho. Está muy chulo. Además, este particularmente, lo que es el mapa y eso, está súper currado. Y hasta tiene su propia banda sonora. Tiene su propio árbol distinto de personajes. Unas armas únicas y unas armaduras bastante poderosas. Tanto que es una pena que yo tenga que hacer esto al final, cuando ya me he pasado el juego, la historia principal. Porque todos tienen nivel 40 y pico. Yo me he terminado el juego en nivel 39, nivel 40, por ahí. Puede que 38, 37 me acabe yo el juego en ese nivel. O sea, yo no podría hacer este DLC. Me parece un poco eso mal, porque es que mira, ya que estoy, lo voy a enseñar, hombre. Es que me hace una nueva... Es completamente nuevo esto, lo de los huecos en medio, que si intensifico las mutaciones. La verdad que me gustaría tener esto en el juego principal también. Había pensado, cuando me pase el juego, comprármelo de oferta cuando esté en Steam. Ahora mismo está de oferta, pero yo ahora mismo no me voy a gastar dinero cuando estoy jugando otra vez. O sea, ya veremos el año que viene o el siguiente. Había pensado en comprármelo cuando esté de oferta y meterle mods. Pepinar Geralt de Rivia, el hacer primero el DLC, conseguir las mejores espadas, las mejores... Ya ser lo que es Geralt de Rivia, porque realmente que tú seas Geralt de Rivia al empezar el juego y vayas a una aldea, encabrones a un tío y ese tío te mate porque es nivel 26, es una mierda. Porque eres Geralt de Rivia, no eres Mosquito Peleón 4. Entonces, pues... Hombre, más que nada por sentir que estás manejando a Geralt de Rivia. Total, ya me he pasado el juego. Es la segunda vez que me lo he pasado. Y... Porque la primera vez me lo pasé en la Play 4. Que por cierto lo estoy viendo ahí. Aquí está. Aquí está. Luego me compré los DLC digitales. Cuando estaban de oferta. Pero nunca llegué a jugarlos. Así soy yo. Un gilipollas de manual. Y entonces me lo volví a comprar para Nintendo Switch. Que la verdad que, como digo siempre, es un privilegio poder jugar a un videojuego de estas características en portátil. Y nada. Me lo he vuelto a pasar. Y estoy jugando los DLC por primera vez. Y bastante guapo, la verdad. Muy chulo. Muy currado. Muy, muy, muy currado. Muy guapo. En fin. Y la verdad que no me costó barato. Lo tengo digital. No, ni siquiera me lo compré en físico. Y me alegro, ¿eh? Me alegro porque, verás. Eso de tener que estar colocando... A veces es un poco tedioso. Y a veces... No entiendo por qué. El Metal Gear Collection, por ejemplo, se tiene que instalar cada vez que lo pongo. Ya lo he instalado 4 veces. No entiendo el por qué. Así que bueno, es más cómodo. La verdad que en Nintendo Switch, por alguna razón, me resulta más cómodo tener los juegos digitales. Aparte de que es muy cómodo, porque los metes en las tarjetas, en las micro SD. Que las originales, verdad, que son carillas, valen 20 euros la de ciento y pico. Pero mi otra tarjeta es de AliExpress, me costó 4 pavos y ya llevo 3 o 4 años con ella. Y me funciona de putísima madre, o sea, igualito que la Play 4, que tengo ahí el disco duro de 6 TB, que ese me costó, y de oferta, casi 200 pavos. Una barbaridad. Entonces, hombre, las posibilidades que me da la Nintendo Switch para aumentar la memoria son infinitamente más cómodas. Eso también era una ventaja en la Wii U. En la Wii U expandí la memoria con un USB. Y tengo videojuegos metidos en el USB. No la tengo pirateada ni es nada. Vamos, yo en la Wii U me he comprado videojuegos retro digitales. Pero comprados, nada de emuladores ni nada de nada. Tengo emuladores en el ordenador. Pero yo mis consolas las tengo completamente intactas. Las tres únicas consolas que he tenido piratas ha sido la Play 1, la Play 2 y la PSP. Mi Play 1 está moribunda, mi Play 2 está muerta y mi PSP moribunda también. Los juegos de Play 1 juego en la PlayStation 3, PSP me compré otra y PlayStation 2 me compré otra. O sea, mi PSP y mi PlayStation 2 actuales no están pirateadas. Eran otros tiempos, era pequeño, en fin, no me voy a excusar, todo el mundo... Yo sé lo que he hecho y el porqué y me da exactamente igual. Igual que he hecho eso, me he gastado cientos de euros en videojuegos retros en Wii U. O sea, se me puede comer los huevos de izquierda a derecha, de arriba a abajo. Bueno, pues nada. Coño, casi 2 horas de directo. Estaba más tiempo haciendo gilipolleces. Las pruebas de la fiesta y conversaciones y cinemáticas más que jugando, cojones. Bueno. Venga, pues aquí lo dejo ya. HDMI 1. Y detener transmisión. Hasta luego.